Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the University of Wisconsin-La Crosse Department of Music, we welcome you to Annette Recital Hall, where we present to you this evening the second night in the 2022 La Crosse New Music Festival. Tonight, we welcome Sarah Braley, soprano, and Caleb Vanderswaa, cello. Please take this time to mute all electronic devices, especially those that may make disruptive noise, and be sure to dim those that have bright screens that may distract and disturb others. Remember, eating, drinking, talking, and flash photography are prohibited. Again, welcome and enjoy the performance.
Now this seems slightly redundant, but I just want to welcome you to the second night of the New Music Festival. I'm David Deese, composer, but also professor of theory and composition here, and the director of the festival. Tonight, I am thrilled to welcome Sarah Braley and Caleb Vanderswaa. They're performing a program of just voice and cello. Sarah's a wonderful person, Caleb's a wonderful person. They've been wonderful to work with, and they've been talking to our students and ran out into the community. It's been a fantastic experience. So please help me in welcoming Sarah Braley and Caleb Vanderswaa.
Good evening, everyone. It's such a special pleasure to be here in my hometown and seeing so many old friends and faces I haven't seen in so many years who mean a lot to me. So thank you so much for coming. Thank you to Dr. Deese and UWL for having us. As many of you know, I'm Sarah Braley, and I grew up here and began as a cellist, so I'm always very happy to be able to collaborate with cellists. This is my friend Kayla van der Zwaag, who I met when I lived in New York, and this first piece that we just performed is entitled Loisaida, which is a Puerto Rican nickname for the Lower East Side in New York City, and that first poem is by Bimbo Rivas, who was an activist in the 70s and 80s, and Jesse Montgomery, the composer, also grew up in New York and so felt a deep connection to that neighborhood, and it feels appropriate to open the program with this little homage to New York as well. So it's happy to be in my original home celebrating one of my other homes. The next piece we will perform for you is a little more traditional, we would, I suppose, say, by Dmitri Shostakovich, Russian composer. It's the first song in a cycle of pieces on the poetry of Alexander Blok, and each song is for a different instrumentation of soprano, cello, violin, piano, different combinations. And so this first song is the only one in the cycle that's just for cello and voice, and the text is about the sad story of Ophelia.
Thank you. thank you so much. And of course, another hand for the composer of that last piece. The next piece we're going to be playing for you is an arrangement, or maybe a reimagining, of the Lou Reed Velvet Underground song, Heroine. And this is one of Lou Reed's and one of Velvet Underground's greatest songs, and I don't know if you're familiar with it. It is a repetitive, driving, it generated a lot of, I have a little trouble talking about it because it generated a lot of controversy at the time, because what it is an exploration of taking heroin. And this is one of Lou Reed's most controversial songs. And in his time, it generated a lot of controversy because people were not sure if this piece, if this song was something that was celebrating the drug use or whether it was something that was a reflection of it or a combination of it. And it was an ambiguity that Lou Reed felt in his own life and his own issues with addiction. And it's a song that he eventually stopped performing towards the end of his life because he felt like it was being misunderstood and as a celebration of the drug use. And but there's a tension to the song that exists between those things. And this is a really remarkable reimagining of it by David Lang, in which the piece, the song, the original song, is basically just two chords that repeat over and over and again. And it's almost this, there's kind of a drone that exists underneath. And what David Lang realized and reimagined was that he took that and kind of turned it into an almost minimalist or post-minimalist exploration of that and kind of expanded that. And what I think is most interesting about this arrangement is that it takes that ambiguity that exists in the original about the attitude to the subject matter, and I think it expands upon the ambiguity. So you have what is actually at times quite a lush arrangement with a lot of beauty to it, but surrounding what is a very complicated and nuanced song in history. So this is Heroine by Lou Reed, arranged by David Lang. Hope you enjoy. The next piece we're going to be playing for you is Nine Settings of Loreen Nideker's poetry by Harrison Birtwistle, the late great British composer. And Loreen Nideker is actually a Wisconsin poet. She lived most of her life on the Black Hawk Island, I believe. Is that right? I think so. Black Hawk River. On an island, in a river, in Wisconsin, she spent most of her life. And a lot of her poetry is about nature and about her impressions of her surroundings. And it often is in this, as you'll see if you look at the text in the poem, in these very haiku-like poetry. They're just images that move in and out that reflects her impressions. And that was what attracted Birtwistle to her poetry, was he speaks about her, the fragile nature of her poetry and about how it is ephemeral. And that's something he tries to capture in the music, and you'll hear. And we had a really interesting experience the other day because we had the opportunity as part of our residency to play at Central High School here in town, which is where Sarah is an alum. And we played a few moments of this, and we were talking to the high school students about it and getting their impressions, and one of them said that her impression of it was that the music sounded like the poetry. And I thought that was a really perceptive way to think about it, because this music is... it's not so much a setting of the poetry, or it's not so much, you'll hear the music, it's not like a song, but it's like an expansion of the poetry. It's the poetry with added colors, added sounds, added nuance, and I think it's, and I hope you'll enjoy it.
Thank you.
We had a lot of fun putting that cycle together. We've done, I guess, one other project together, just the two of us, although we've worked together in other capacities with other groups. But that cycle, it's our premiere for you guys. So, and there was just, you know, obviously so much in the poetry and so much in the music, and we look forward to doing it again because there's just so much to delve into. Thank you. So I would like to thank again Dr. Dees and UWL and Mary Tollefson, I know she's here somewhere, for having us. It's just been a pleasure to be here in the past few days in the incredible weather, which we all know is not normal, but Caleb doesn't know. So, and to see so many old friends and have a chance to visit my high school and meet some of the current students there, it's been a really special trip. So we have one more set for you by composer Heather Gilligan, who is a contemporary composer, friend and colleague of mine. She teaches composition at Keene State in New Hampshire. And this is a set of four songs. The cycle is entitled Living in Light, which is a snippet from the last poem. And the poetry is by the American poet Sarah Teasdale, who has a Midwestern connection. She was involved in a poet writers society of women in Chicago for a time and led a fairly tragic life but had a pretty big output. So these are four poems, most of which are very contemplative and I would say there's a lot of mournfulness in them, but there are also some moments of real brightness and lightness. So we've also really enjoyed getting to know this cycle. So thank you again for being such an incredibly attentive audience, and I look forward to catching up with all of you afterwards.
I have come.
That's the hometown. It's the hometown audience.
Yeah. I just feel so comfortable with you guys. Wow, I'm really sorry.